When conducting qualitative research, what type of data counts as qualitative data? In this Delve video, we're going to talk about qualitative data, what it is, how it compares to quantitative data, the different types of qualitative data you can collect, and how you can analyze it. Qualitative data is data that is descriptive and depicts qualities or characteristics, whereas quantitative data is numerical. If there were a group of people in a room, qualitative data could describe how they feel, what they look like, what clothes they're wearing, or the motivations of why they're here. Whereas quantitative data about the same group may include the number of people in the group, their age, or the temperature in the room. Many of the blind spots of quantitative data are addressed by qualitative data. For example, quantitative data can tell you that the test scores in a particular school district have outperformed other school districts in the surrounding area, but it can't tell you why it's happening. Alternatively, qualitative data can tell you that the educators in the high-performing district have strong leadership, have high buy-in among staff members, and have invested in a consistent approach to a particular style of instruction. The combination of this quantitative and qualitative data can help inform changes that can improve the performance of the surrounding districts. Next, we'll describe different types of qualitative data and discuss ways you can analyze qualitative data to make sense of it. One primary way to collect qualitative data is through in-depth interviews or focus groups. When conducting those, you can collect audio recordings or video recordings, which you can transcribe into written word in the form of transcriptions. These audio recordings, video recordings, and transcripts are all forms of qualitative data. A lot of qualitative data can be created through your own observations. During an observation, you might take photos or videos of your research participants, their working or living spaces, or any other artifacts related to your research. You can also take notes where you describe what you saw during an interview or an observation. Qualitative data can also be collected from research participants. Participants can create qualitative data artifacts such as diary accounts. Diary accounts are collected as part of diary studies, where participants record diary entries about their activities or experiences in the form of videos, text messages, emails, or written accounts. Research participants can also fill out open-ended surveys as another form of research participant-derived qualitative data. Qualitative data can also be collected from existing sources. There are a number of sources like documents, such as public records, handbooks, policy outlines, plans, curriculums, personal documents like calendars, emails, or physical artifacts like handbooks, flyers, posters, or agendas. They can also be videos, such as films, news reports, or videos of events. Photos from the events and news are also forms of qualitative data. Previously conducted qualitative research can also be used as qualitative data, such as case studies. Case studies are studies or investigations of a particular person or a group of people. Lastly, social media can provide an almost unending source of qualitative data. These include tweets, Facebook posts, YouTube videos, TikTok videos, blogs, or any other form of content that you can find online. These are just some examples of qualitative data, and in no way is it a complete or exhaustive list. Now, let's discuss how to analyze qualitative data and compare it to how you analyze quantitative data. When analyzing quantitative data, you make meaning through different types of mathematical techniques, such as mean, median, standard deviations, or linear regression. These methods, however, cannot be used on qualitative data, which has its own forms of analysis to extract meaning. For qualitative data, you can use methodologies and methods such as grounded theory, thematic analysis, content analysis, narrative analysis, and other techniques. Each of these qualitative analysis techniques includes a process called qualitative coding. Qualitative coding is a common tool that allows you to interpret, organize, analyze, and structure your qualitative data for your final research report or narrative. If you want to learn how to code your qualitative data, check out our video, Intro to Qualitative Coding with Delve. If you've collected qualitative data and are ready to start your qualitative analysis, check out Delve, software for qualitative coding. You can start a free trial at www.delvetool.com/get-started.